My belief is that Honorable Moses Kuria seems to know what they did. He seems to have interacted with the people at Harambe House, very senior persons, some of them were at State House as well as Harambe House, who allegedly came together and assembled a number of people to serve as witnesses or to be recruited and told to say that they are witnesses. Unfortunately, some of them ended up to us, and we provided 3 months protection support. If it is true that Kuria's allegations are based on fact and not fiction, then the International Criminal Court has no moral authority to proceed with this. No, my link with the ICC is when the witnesses of Waki Commission began complaining that they were being targeted. They were being targeted for harassment. They came to this office, and as a human rights organization, we began looking for ways of having them get protection services. And that is actually my aim. And the fact that I have been fighting for the rights of the victims of post-election violence, and as I've said, that is not going to change even after this statement. I'm just going to proceed on. I'll always stand out for justice for the victims of this case. But I'm saying also, you see, William Ruto and Joshua Sang are also Kenyans, and they are human beings. And as a human rights defender, I cannot discriminate. If indeed the evidence that has been used to prosecute them at The Hague was manufactured somewhere in Harambe House by Kuria and others, then it is unfair for us to proceed with that case.